Odysseus and his men were sailing near the island of Thrinacia, from whence they heard the mooing of the cows and oxen that lived there. Odysseus's comrades yearned for supplies and rest, but the king of Ithaca was told by Circe that that island might bring complete ruin to his men. He attempted to convince them to move away from the island. However, his men were greatly disgruntled, even to the point of mutiny. Odysseus consented to take them there, as long as they promised not to touch the cattle on that island, which was owned by the god Helios. They agreed and headed for the beach. Shortly after sheltering the ship in a cave to protect it from the winds, a storm raged over the island. Odysseus informed his men that they were to consume only the supplies offered by the sorceress Circe, while leaving Helios's animals in peace. Inclement weather and unforgiving winds kept Odysseus stranded on that island for months. The supplies were very close to running out. Odysseus said it was best for his men to try to fish and gather whatever berries and roots they could find, but to keep away from the sun god's oxen. While on one of his hunts, the hero reached the top of a hill. Feeling close to the gods, he asked them to help him. He felt as if the gods had sent him a peaceful sleep, and right there he took a nap. He would wake up smelling the distinctive aroma of roasting meat. Nearby, his men were grilling calf meat, as they had slaughtered the best animals to appease the gods' wrath. They would rather bear the risk of divine vengeance than the ordeal of starving to death. Odysseus was desperate to witness the scenario he had feared so much. The revenge of the gods would come soon. In heaven, the sun accused men of profaning his sacred cattle. He said that he would go to Hades to illuminate the dead, while the earth and heavens would no longer see his light. Zeus pleaded with Helios not to stop illuminating the world, as he would end the lives of those responsible for such a crime. The headwind ceased, and Odysseus and his men set off, leaving the island of Thrinacia behind. But the thunderbolts in the sky pointed to Zeus's foul mood. A powerful lightning strike shattered the shipmast, collapsing on the helmsman. Further lightning struck the ship, utterly destroying it. Many of Odysseus's men died by electrocution, while others drowned in the sea waters. Laertes's son survived by grabbing onto the planks of the ship's wreckage. He would be the only one not to have his body swallowed by the sea. He would drift for a while until realizing that the currents were taking him towards a dreadful fate. Odysseus was once again heading for the gorge of Scylla and Charybdis. The wreckage was being tugged by Charybdis's whirlpool, and his end seemed inevitable. But he managed to reach the branches of a fig tree that sprang up by the walls. Hanging from it, the hero waited until Charybdis had swallowed all the water, as he always did. The water flow reversed, and Odysseus jumped onto the debris spewed out by Charybdis, using the strength of his arms and legs as he attempted his best to distance himself from that place. For days, Odysseus was adrift at sea, until he was carried to the shores of the Ogygia Island, where the nymph Calypso lived. After describing his stay on Calypso's island and how he had arrived in the land of the Phaeacians, Odysseus concluded his adventures at the court of King Alcinous. Overwhelmed with emotion, Odysseus felt in his heart the pain of recalling that almost all of his companions who perished on his journey cried out for his name in despair before they took their last breath.